Hello, welcome to my studio again. Happy New Year, it's 2022. If you are trying to keep in with your goals, we're gonna start total body workouts. So today you're gonna see me do a little bit of jumping. We're gonna be doing some heavy lifts. You can see the bars here. And we're gonna be doing a little bit of an easier circuit at the end. So make sure that you have water. If you do not have barbells, if you're not as advanced, that's okay, use dumbbells. You can also do this workout body weight. You just have to focus on squeezing your muscles as you do the movements. As always, make sure that you are listening to your body and don't do anything that your doctor hasn't told you you should do or that doesn't feel right. So I'm gonna do my best to give you modifications, but we might as well get started. So we're gonna pick up a slow jog. If you can't jog, you're gonna kick your heels back. Otherwise, pick up a slow jog. We are gonna be doing some exercises that include jumping today. Again, if jumping is not good for your joints or your doctor has told you not to, you can do these without the jump, and I will explain that as we go along. Now, I think you heard me mention in the beginning that this is gonna be a total body workout. I prefer total body workouts because they're a little bit more time efficient, which is good because I know a lot of the people watching this are probably busy working parents. All right, and then you're gonna take that a little bit wide, slide out onto that knee. The first part of our workout is going to be the part where we do some of the jumping. It's gonna serve partially as our warm up, but also anytime you're doing ballistic type movements, you wanna do those earlier on in the workout while you're not too tired. All right, so we are gonna go from a push press to a squat jump to a plank jump over, and you'll see me, I'll demonstrate those in a second. So for our push press, if you have some sort of this is actually an old broom handle, but you're gonna start right here, and as we squat, you're gonna push it up overhead. Now I like to have something that you can hold on to like this because you can push it back behind yourself and you're gonna get a nice stretch through the front of the body. So again, this is part warm up. This is not gonna be a jumping movement. If you don't have a broom handle or something you can just use your body weight and push your arms overhead. So squatting down, we're practicing our squat, making sure everything is moving okay. Make sure you sit back onto those heels. As you come up, you're gonna push that front back and over your head, get a nice stretch. We're gonna do 10 of these, that was 5. Keep your chin up, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now we're gonna move into a squat jump. With jump, you have to make sure that you push your hips back and you want to keep your knees soft so that you land soft. So your squat jump starts here, you're gonna jump, land soft, come all the way back down. We're gonna do 10 of those. It's gonna get the heart rate up a little bit. Put the hair up real quick. All right, squat down. Jump, land soft, keep the chin up. There's 3. If you cannot jump, you can just do squats. Eight, 9, and 10. All right, next one is going to be a plank hop over. If you don't have anything to hop your legs over, don't worry about it. If you can't hop, just hold your plank. So you're gonna do a straight arm plank, and I'm gonna use my bar as my jump. You're gonna do 5 each way, total of 10. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. All right, heart rate should be up right now. Go ahead and take a short break. You can grab your water. We're gonna do that 2 more times through. All right, you're gonna grab your broom handle again if you have it. But we gotta start here. Start at the chest, push overhead. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And put that down. Squat jumps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And then plank hopovers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And resting again. Okay, we got one more time through that circuit. So, bar starts here and pressing overhead. Remember to keep your chin up. Push your hips back like you're gonna sit down on something behind you. There's 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Get that down again. All right, squat jumps. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. All right, and then you can really feel that in the legs. All right, and then your hopovers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay, take a break. Grab some water for the next 2 exercises. Make sure that you have bar or dumbbell or a band, and I will be right back.
For over 2 decades, Zoom Internet has been a leader in broadband. And now, we've built the network of the future with 10G. 10 times faster than gig speed internet. Able to support the limitless demand of the future. Providing advanced security for connected devices. Our fiber network is unmatched. Zoom from Armstrong. The internet of tomorrow is here today.
Okay, now that we've got our warm-up completed, we are going to be doing, we're gonna superset 2 exercises back to back, and we're actually gonna do it 4 times through. We are gonna take a little bit of rest between each of the four sets. We are going to superset a deadlift and a row. So I have my 2 bars here with weight on them for deadlift is the bigger one, and then row is gonna be the smaller one. If you don't have bars, you can use dumbbells. So you just want to go with a weight that challenges you. We're going to be doing 10 repetitions for each exercise. If you don't have weights at all, you can use bands, or you can use body weight too. You just have to make sure that you are squeezing your muscles while you're doing the exercise if you're only gonna use body weight. So we're gonna start with the deadlift. The deadlift works the back side of the legs and your rear end. So with your deadlift, you're gonna hold your bar or your dumbbells here. They're gonna slide down to just below the knee, and then you're gonna pull up. You wanna keep your back nice and straight. You wanna keep your shoulders set back. So there's not a whole lot of movement in the upper body. It's mostly in the lower. Keeping the weight towards the back of your foot. All right, now since I'm using a heavier bar, I'm also gonna use an alternating grip. So one hand's gonna be underhand, one is over. So we're gonna go for 10 reps on this. So make sure you set yourself up. Pick up, just below the knee. Squeeze your rear end to come up. Keep the weight towards the back of your foot. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, and 10. Set down with good form. I'm gonna step over to my next bar. And now we're gonna do a bent over row. So, dumbbells, bar, doesn't matter. You're gonna take your weight and you're going to pull up to your chest or your lower or your upper abdomen. I always start from a standing position. Slight bend of the knees. Gonna pull that right up to your abdomen. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, last one, 10. All right, now we're gonna take a rest. Hopefully you took a little bit of a breather, grabbed some water, caught your breath, let your muscles recover a little bit. We're gonna go for our next set of deadlifts followed by rows. One, two, remember you could be doing this with dumbbells too. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. And then moving to the smaller bar, gonna do rows. There's one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, two more, nine, and 10. And take a break. All right, set number three. Make sure you're doing this, that you're using good form. If you find that you're losing your form as you get further along in your sets, you may have to drop weight too, which is actually what I did for my row. I took a little bit of weight off the bar. Four, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 1 more, and 10. All right, we're gonna move up to that bar for our row. Feel a little bit better here. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, still challenging. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And resting again. All right, we got our final set. So you can see that a way to get a little bit more volume when you're going heavy, and this will allow you to go heavier on your weights, is that we do more sets, but lower reps. And you could even, if you're going very heavy, you could do 5 sets, but only 5 reps per set. So that just depends on your equipment and your level. I like to do my workouts this way so I can get a couple of heavy lifts, get a well-rounded workout. There's 1, 2, remember to squeeze from behind on this. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Step down with good form. And then we got our last set of rows. Even doing these, you want to keep the weight towards the back of your foot. Six, 7, 8, 9, and 10. All right, and break.
From high school sports to community events and beyond, you can find all of your favorite local shows on the Armstrong Neighborhood Channel.
Hi, I'm Kristen Gambassini from Craft Table. You can check out my show as well as other local favorites such as Medina Minute, Cooking with Kelly, and Leisure and Literature on Armstrong Neighborhood Channel.
Check us out right now on Channel 100 or search Armstrong Neighborhood Channel on YouTube for playlists and much more. Spirit, town pride, community. This is the Armstrong Neighborhood Channel.
All right, so now that our heavy work is out of the way, we are going to do 2 sets, 2 rounds through a circuit style total body workout. And we're gonna do a little bit higher reps on this. So again, we're getting a range of rep work, we're getting a range of the types of weights that we're using today. But again, if you don't have weights and you're just moving your body, you're just trying to get a little bit of workout, don't overthink how heavy you need to go for this. As long as you're moving, and you're working on strength and your fitness goals, that's all that really matters. So we are gonna go to 15 repetitions for the next exercises. We are gonna start with a goblet squat. So you're gonna hold your weight, if you have a weight, you're gonna hold it right at your chest, and you're gonna squat down just like we did with our squat jumps and our push press in the beginning. So squatting down, I like to hold a weight right in front of me because it forces me to keep my chin up. Here's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, keep your knees out, 8, 9, 10, remember to go to 15, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Okay, we'll set our weight down. And next we're gonna do a pull over. So you do not have to have a weight for this. A bench is helpful. You can do this if you're on, you can just do this lying on the floor too. So you're gonna grab your dumbbell. Make sure you're right at the edge of your bench. Your head is right at the edge. And if you can, you'll want your feet on the floor for stability. The dumbbell's gonna go back overhead and you're gonna pull it to right up over your chest. Now, if you're doing this on the floor, you may need to hold your weight long ways so that it doesn't hit the floor, okay? Make sure you have a good grip on that weight so that you don't drop it on yourself. Don't go overly heavy with this one. Anytime you're pushing weight over your head or your chest, you want to make sure you can maintain control. Three, we are going to go to 15 on this. Four. Five. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. We're gonna set them on the floor, and we're gonna use the bench again. You can do the next exercise from standing if you don't have a bench. If you're using weights, you're gonna want light weights for this. We're gonna do a bent over fly. So if you're seated, you need to be sitting right on the edge. Your feet need to be forward so that you can reach underneath your legs. If you're standing, you're just gonna be in a bent over position. Same thing, but your dumbbells will come in front of your legs. All right, we are gonna do again 15 of these. So our last circuits are a little higher rep, a little lower weight. There's one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Okay, we got one more exercise in the circuit. 15 is gonna be calf raises. So you're just gonna come up onto your toes and then back down. So let's do 15 of these. So just doing a little bit of accessory work. Really important to work your calves. Don't forget about them. Four, five, six, seven. You feel like body weight is not enough? You've been working your calves out, you can go ahead and hold weight for this. There's 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Okay, go ahead and take a break, grab some water. We're gonna do that one more time through before we do a couple of stretches at the end. We gotta do our final round through our high rep exercises. So we're gonna go back and start with that squat. So remember your weight goes right under your chin. You're gonna keep your head up, pushing your hips back. 15 reps of this. There's one, two, 3, 4, 5. Don't allow your knees to come in as you squat down. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Put that to the side. We're gonna do that pullover again. So make sure that you get yourself set up on the bench. Remember to make sure you've got a good grip on your weight. Start right over the chest, back behind the head, and that's one. Two. Make sure you're breathing. Three. Four. I don't know how you couldn't be after all those squats. Five. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. All right, set that to the side. Grab your lighter weights for the reverse fly. So this is actually working the shoulder blades, so your upper back and the backs of your shoulders. A lot of times people forget about those areas. Arms staying relatively straight. Three, remember you can do this from standing if you don't have a bench. Seven, going to 15, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. You probably feel why you want to use low weight on this. One more. 15. Okay. And then my last one is calf raises. So remember, if you feel like it's too easy to do a body weight, you can go ahead and hold weights during this too. So coming up onto those toes as high as you can. There's two, three, four, five, six, seven, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, there's 14, last one, and 15. All right, so we'll take a quick break and then we'll do a couple of stretches and you'll be done for the day. All right, so we completed a workout, did total body. You worked every major muscle group in your body. Time to do a little bit of stretching so you bring those stress hormones back down. And also you stretch a couple of the areas that tend to be tight on most people. So this is called the runner stretch. And if you sit a lot, you probably have tight hip flexors. And this may present as low back pain when you spend a lot of time on your feet or walking. So one of the ways that you can help prevent that back pain is by doing this hip flexor stretch. So we've got one knee down and you're leaning forward onto that foot. If you have good enough balance, you can lift the one arm so you're creating a long side. And you're gonna hold this stretch for 20 to 30 seconds. And then you're gonna back off of that. We're gonna switch sides. It can be helpful to have a chair next to you or something to hold on to if you struggle with the balance. All right, so get yourself set up. Lean forward onto that front leg. When you find your balance, you're gonna reach up with that arm so you're creating a long side. You can even reach a little over center line. And then the last stretch we're gonna do is gonna be seated. Again, people tend to be very tight in the inner thigh. So we're gonna do the butterfly stretch. As you're doing these stretches, you wanna make sure you're taking a few deep breaths. So again, we're bringing our nervous system back down. That exercise we just did caused a little bit of stress. It's good stress, but it does cause a little bit of stress, so we wanna bring all of that back down. You can close your eyes as you do this if you want to. All right. So, go ahead and release that stretch. Thank you so much for joining me today for this workout. If there's anything that you would like me to do specifically for the Armstrong Neighborhood Channel, definitely make sure that you comment and I will do my best to have them make a video about that particular topic as relating to exercise. Otherwise, I hope that you enjoyed this and I hope you all have a fabulous day. If you want to reach out to me, you can go to my website, which is www.kellyhaley.fit. Thanks.